We'll flash again, Yusek Rodolfo, the SIRV of Guo Huaping, and the BOI letter to the BI dated 4th June 2024. Familiar po ba kayo sa mga dokumentong ito at pwede nyo po bang ipaliwanag sa amin ano po yung konteksto ng mga dokumentong ito?
Yes, Your Honor. Honorable Chair and honorable members of the committee, we actually received 3 requests on information related to this hearing. One is from Commissioner Norman Tansinco on a letter that he sent to our DTI Secretary Alfredo Pascual and the BOI Executive Director Bobby Fondevilla. This was dated June 3, inquiring on the complete details of the Special Investors Resident Visa application of Juan Guo Jian Zong. And we replied, Your Honor, June 3, same date, but was received the day after by the Bureau of Immigration, informing the Bureau of Immigration that as per our records, the said foreign national and his dependents were previous holders of SIRV issued pursuant to provisions of Book 5 of Executive Order 226, otherwise known as the Omnibus Investment Code of 1987, with the following details. So the SIRVs were issued to Guo Jian Zong, the principal, with date of birth 16 September 1958, to Xi Xiu Mei, the dependent spouse, date of birth September 9, 1961, to Guo Ling Ling, the dependent daughter, date of birth November 21, 1982, and to Guo Lina, dependent daughter, September 15, 1986, yung date of birth po. The SIRV status, this was canceled in May 23, 2003. And then
Yusek, yung mga pangalang binanggit nyo dun sa naunang SIRV na in-issue are different from the names we see here, so we're presuming these are different dependents, or we can say they are not the same as appear in these documents.
Yung sa pangalan po, but we have no competence. We're not the competent authority to determine whether pareho silang mga katauhan po. But may I also proceed, Madam Chair, on the official request that we received from the Senate Committee on Women, Children, Family Relations, Gender and Gender Equality dated 19th June and 20th June. So on a Lin Wenji, Chinese national, and as I mentioned, former holder of SIRV. Following are the details of the said foreign national based on the files on record. So this refers to Lin Wenji. Ms. Lin applied for SIRV along with her dependents Guo Hua Ping, Guo Jiang Long, and Guo Xiang Dian. Their SIRV were granted 25 May 2000. She invested $75,000 in Triumph Embroidery Center Incorporated, formerly Hua Fei Embroidery Center Incorporated, a business enterprise engaged in rendering embroidery services. The said firm is considered an eligible form of investment under the SIRV rules and regulations. The existence of the said investment was confirmed via an ocular inspection conducted by the BOI on May 22, 2002. The following documents were submitted for the revalidation of their SIRB because this is part of the SIRB process po. Valid Chinese passports, alien certificates of registration, SEC registration, and articles of incorporation of Hua Fei Embroidery Center, a certificate of inward remittance issued by the Banco Central of Filipinas, that time dated September 30, 1999. Now, in line with our rules, after the validation of foreign nationals' eligibility for SIRB, their names were endorsed to the Bureau of Immigration for the grant of the visa. The Bureau of Immigration conducts its own validation process and then acts on the BOI endorsement by implementing the visas in sticker form onto the holder's passports. Their SIRV were cancelled on August 22, 2011, as represented by the letter of the holder's authorized representative. They were applying for Special Resident Retirees Visa or SRRV with the Philippine Retirement Authority. This was as of September 12, 2011 po. Upon verification by BOI with PRA, the said foreign nationals are currently active holders of the SRRV. Now, we also provided, Madam Chair, copies of the following documents to the Senate in reply to the June 19 and June 20th letters: the accomplished SIRV application form, the initial report of investment by the applicant, the accomplished deed of undertaking, the certification of inward remittance issued by the Banco Central Registration Department, the certification issued by Huafei Embroidery Center Incorporated certifying Li Wenyi as a stockholder of the firm, the articles of incorporation and bylaws of Huafei Embroidery Center Incorporated, the annual income tax return and balance sheet for calendar years ending December 31, 2001 of Huafei Embroidery Center duly received by the Bureau of Internal Revenue, the affidavit on the capacity to invest of at least $75,000, the certifications issued by the Department of Health National Quarantine Office, the passport bio pages and visa stamps, and the biometrics, in particular, the right thumbprint of the said personalities. Please be informed also that the SIRV holders are required to physically report to our office upon approval of their visas to have their pictures and biometrics captured for issuance of the SIRV ID. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Yusek. So, do you confirm the authenticity of these documents related to the SIRV of Guo Huaping?
Yes, Madam Chair.
Thank you. Ano po yung requirements para sa SIRV application bukod sa maaring nabanggit nyo na kanina? And also, what about the dependents of an applicant? May requirements din po ba kaugnay nila?
Doon po sa principal applicant, nabanggit natin yung mga documentary requirements, pero ang main requirement po is the $75,000 na investment in qualified targeted investments. Ito pong pag sinabi natin qualified investment targets, this would be in shares of stock in corporations engaged in services, manufacturing, or in a publicly listed company. Dati ho, pinapayagan natin yung pag-invest sa condominium units or in a trading enterprise. But since 2002, hindi na ho natin pinapayagan yung mga yon. Doon sa mga dependent ko, in addition to the documentary requirements that I mentioned, they have to be below 21 years old, which would explain ko kung makikita ho natin doon sa birth date ni Guo Huaping nung nag-apply ho sila, nung requested their SIRB to be cancelled in 22 August 2011, lalagpas na ho siya sa 21 years old. Kaya siya we could surmise that is the reason why they transferred to the Philippine Retirement Authority Special Resident Retirees Visa.
Salamat, Yusek. O, patatanungin din natin yung tungkol sa PRA mamaya. Pero dito pa rin sa SIRV ng BOI, required po ba ang personal appearance ng lahat ng aplikante? At may biometrics bang kinukuha ang BOI?
Opo, Madam Chair. The SIRV holders are required to physically report to the Board of Investments upon approval of their visas to have their pictures and biometrics, in particular ho, signature and fingerprint captured para ho to kasi sa issuance ng kanilang SIRV ID. So kailangan po silang mag-physically to report in our offices. In our office, sorry.
And speaking of, kanina binabanggit nyo nga po yung thumbprints, no? Kababanggit nyo ulit ngayon. Normal po ba na yung isang ina i-enter niya yung thumbprint niya para sa minor child niya? So halimbawa, in the case of one of these documents, yung minor child, mga 9 years old, so hindi na po siya baby. At ipapakita po ako dito ulit. Ito po. Even to the naked eye, it looks like dun sa ano kanina, yung slide po na magkasama yung thumbprint ni Lee Wen Ye at yung thumbprint ni Guo Haping. Mukhang magkapareho ang thumbprint nung Lin Wen Ye, yung ina, at yung Guo Haping na dependent daughter. So alam ko rin na yung NBI ay may biometrics ni Guo Haping, so not all is lost. Kaya lang dagdag na nakakalito. At dagdag pa, yung dalawang minor siblings nung Guo Haping dyan sa document na yan, sila naman hindi thumbprint. Ito na muna. Yung magkatabing thumbprint ni Lin Wen Yi at ni Guo Hua Ping, parang magkapareho. I am not a fingerprint expert at all. So, I was just showing it again and sa inyo, USEC, at sa lahat po nating nandirito sa hearing. So, nakakalito nga. So, pero bakit yung dalawa pang minor dependents, minor siblings ni Guo Hua Ping, I cannot ask you why, pero ninonote ko lang, sila, yung dalawa, hindi thumbprint nung ina. Ginamit nila yung sarili nilang thumb. So, bakit kaya? At bakit kaya yung special effort para kay Alice? I'm of course presuming na yung Guo Hua Ping ay si Alice Guo din. Any insights, USEC?
Madam Chair, sa proseso ho namin, dapat, unless infant, pero dapat ho talaga yung, pati yung dependent, i-capture yung kanyang thumbprint. So, assumption of regularity po, on the processes undertaken in 2000, yung ina, yung principal, kinapture yung kanyang thumbprint. Tapos yung si Guo Hua Ping, kinapture din yung kanyang thumbprint. We're not competent to assess kung one and the same yung thumbprint na nakikita ho natin. But these are the thumbprints that we have on record, including dun sa dalawa pang dependent ho.
And of course, and fair enough po, USEC. And of course, yung presumption of regularity is dun sa government agency na nagtumatanggap ng ganitong mga submissions or nagko-conduct ng ganitong mga procedure. So, dapat nga yung BOI. So, tapos, yes sir. Tapos, USEC, kanina nakita nyo rin po yung passport ni Guo Hua Ping. Sa estimation nyo lamang po, bilang layperson, siya nga ba si Alice Guo? If you can offer an opinion.
Madam Chair, we're not the competent authority.
All right. Fair enough, muli, USEC. Ano pong klaseng screening ang ginagawa sa applicants para masiguro na matitinong tao sila or on the level na tao sila sa process na to, na pinapayagang maging residente sa bansa natin?
Thank you, Madam Chair. Sa BOI ho, once we endorse to the Bureau of Immigration, we also endorse ho to the NICA.
I apologize, USEC. Please proceed.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Pagka ho in-endorse namin sa Bureau of Immigration for the issuance of the visa, we also endorse to the NICA. Tapos so si Bureau of Immigration also undertakes their own assessment.
So kumbaga mayroong cross-referencing or validation on the part ng NICA at saka BI.
May I also, Madam Chair, just for context ho, para alam din natin ng lahat, ang number of active SIRV holders ho ng BOI, total ho, principal investors 1,224 at saka dependents 1,124. So ang total ho natin, and the earliest that we have on record, 1988. So cumulative na ho yan, lahat-lahat na ho since 1998 ay 2,348. Medyo konti lang ho, every year ho less than 100 yung ating na-issue na SIRB dahil medyo mahigpit nga po yung mga requirement natin. Thank you.
At mabuti kung mahigpit, probably in this case not mahigpit enough. And gaya ng na-observe nyo, hindi naman napakarami ang 2,000 higit. So dapat kaya nating mas siguruhin pa. So salamat po, USEC. Before we go on, I need to... Just for the processes of the committee to repeat the chair's motion to subpoena Mayor Alice Leal Guo, Lin Wen Ye, Guo Jiang Zhong, Sheila Leal, Simon Leal, and Wesley Leal, and the other earlier mentioned resource persons who are not present and without good reason to be absent in this hearing, to order the issuance of subpoena to those persons.
Yes, Madam Chair, I second the motion. Likewise, I reiterate also my recommendation to invite the former mayor of Bamban so that we will get to the bottom of the truth on how Alice Go came into ascension, into power. Obviously, it was really... she really ran for the position to protect the interests of Tubugo. So again, may the committee, Madam Chair, invite also Mayor Felice, former Mayor Feliciano.
So ordered earlier, sent JV and reiterated by the chair, the invitation to the next hearing to former Mayor Feliciano. And thank you for seconding the order to subpoena the named resource persons. Salamat po.